All right, today another article that I wanted to read out to you and get your thoughts. I don't know if you can access this article. I'll put the link down in the description and I'll give my thoughts about it. It's seriously an article, worth analyzing and thinking about. It's about the UAE. It's an opinion piece by this website, Harzitz or something like that, Harzitz, whatever. Okay. So the piece is written by David Rosenberg. It's an opinion piece. And what he says, the UAE's Mars mission is more about hype than science. So as I read this article, each and every line, I'll give you my analysis. Feel free to share your thoughts as well, because I think it's worth an exchange to have exchange of ideas. So if you feel I'm wrong, feel free. And oh, look at the size of the spider, man. You can see this spider? Fuck, that's a big one. Looks dangerous. Okay, so all right, anyway, so the UAE's Mars mission is more about hype than science. Okay, the first statement in itself, I would agree. Because I see UAE more as a business hub. It is more of a business hub, a PR machine, a public relations, a marketing machine that wants to promote Dubai as a business hub, a lifestyle hub, a place where you can bring your money and settle down. And UAE keeps investing into projects that give it a positive spin or make it look like amazing. For example, Burj Khalifa, the tallest tower. You know, tourists come there to take photographs. Hollywood movies have shot over there. Dubai Mall, which is the largest, that's for tourists. The failed Palm Islands, only one is functional, rest two are failed. The World Islands, nothing but a cash grab. They took the money, they didn't deliver. Even the airport, Al Maktoum. So, you see, all these projects are designed to attract tourists, bring in more people, with the main intention that please, you know, if you're rich, you have money, come here. So I don't see anything wrong in that, but the point I'm trying to say is there's an element of truth to this first statement. So it's more about hype. Okay, the Emirates' Mars strategy is to project the image of a scientific prowess and hope the reality one day will catch up. Good luck with that. See, UAE wants to, at least Dubai, wants to show we are right in the front. We are innovative. We are, you know, we are the first. They want to be the first in everything, like sending the first Emirati to space. Now this Mars mission. Now, let's give credit where credit is due. It is commendable. It is commendable because none of the other Emirates. Ajman is dead. Sharjah focused on cultural and traditional values and education. Abu Dhabi is focusing on building a very robust economy. And it's, you know, more modest. Ras Al Khaimah, Fujairah, nobody knows even if they exist. Even people in UAE just look at, okay, I just want to go near the mountains, total silence, I'll go to Ras Al Khaimah or Fujairah. So there's nothing there. So in that way, if you look at it, Dubai is to be admired. And credit should be given where credit is due. And Dubai has done what even a country could not do. Like Oman has not been able to do it. Kuwait has not done it. Not that they can't do it, but they have not done it. Saudi has not managed to accomplish some of the things that Dubai has managed. So we have to give credit where credit is due, and it's really commendable. Okay. But however, Dubai trying to promote science, that's not going to happen. The reason being is one is the religion, which is Islam, which science and Islam don't get along in quite a number of ways and means. Like, try explaining to someone in science that there was a prophet who sat on a winged horse, flew off to the moon, and split the moon in two halves. I doubt anyone in the scientific community would take this person seriously. However, in the tenets of Islam, this is a reality. Prophet Muhammad, he sat on a winged horse. He flew off to the moon. And the moon split in, you know, two halves or whatever. So all this nonsense, these funny beliefs or this ridiculous claims, it's not just Islam. All religions have funny claims, which they can't substantiate. So science and Islam don't go hand in hand. Sorry, it doesn't work that way. Okay, next one. Then he says, if the Emirates Mars mission had wanted to cap its success this week in getting the Amal space probe into orbit around Mars with a quote equal to parts dramatic and honest, it would have echoed Neil Armstrong proclaiming, one small step for mankind, one giant leap for Emirati PR. Nicely put, it's very witty. I find the statement funny. He's a good writer. And it's true. UAE always wants to make sure that it's in the headlines. And kudos to them, because they must have put a lot of effort for this. Let's give the United Arab Emirates credit where credit is due. Sending a probe to Mars, getting into orbit, is a remarkable scientific and engineering achievement that only a handful of countries have done. So like I've said, let's give a round of applause to Dubai and the leadership, okay? Including, coincidentally, China too this week. Amal's task of mapping Mars' atmosphere is a legitimate scientific enterprise. But the mission is less about a Mars orbit than it is about UAE spin. Less like much that the Emirates does, especially its most glittering member, Dubai, it is about creating an image in the hope that appearance will eventually translate to reality. I think it is that statement, build it and they will come. Dubai always builds stuff. Like they build the Jabal Ali port when there was no demand. They build Burj Al Arab even though there's no. They build Dubai Mall even though there's no need for that. They build, Burj Khalifa. So they always have believed that if you build it, people will come. But this has failed, where projects like apartments, buildings, villas, communities, investment opportunities are there. So it has not worked for everything. Okay, build the planet's biggest mall and tourist shopper will come. Label a hotel a 7-star property and you'll become the byword for over-the-top luxury. Establish branches of Louvre and Guggenheim and you will be recognized as a center of culture and art. Send a mission to Mars and you are on the way of becoming a scientific powerhouse. Very keen observation. If you actually look at it, what he's saying is true. Because UAE always, you know, builds one or two things here and there. And then wants to promote itself as it has all the bells and whistles of, a luxurious brand or a successful brand. Now, in the defense of Dubai, still, they are doing something which others are not doing. Look at Oman. Can Oman compare? Oman is a whole country. Can it compare to Dubai? Absolutely not. Look at Kuwait. Even though they are much more resources than UAE. In fact, look at Iraq for that matter. Forget Iran. Iraq itself. Complete nothing. Absolutely nothing. So, I will give credit to Dubai here. Now it says, creating that image is more important than science and engineering. That is true. UAE is all about image. If you check the Instagram or Facebook, see how many people are flexing their wealth, their money, their cars. This has become a habit and become a part of the culture. Once upon a time, UAE's culture was about humility, about being desert nomads, simplicity. But today, social media has totally destroyed that. Okay, it's like the attention-seeking syndrome, which is why Sheikh Mohammed, if you actually look at it, he's the only ruler that is on Twitter, on Facebook, on TikTok. Show me which other UAE leader is busy marketing himself there. He likes to promote himself as a enterprising, young, dynamic leader, even though his age. But he likes to promote that, and there's nothing to criticize there. At least he's doing something that others are not doing, and that has to be appreciated. So I'm not criticizing him here. Okay. Thus, plans are afoot to build a Mars science city outside Dubai. That is as funny as, you could not, Mars science city, you could not create outsource city properly. You could not create academic cities, a disaster. Not disaster, it's barely surviving. International city, what is it? Falcon city, what happened? Bavardi city, what happened? You know, the world islands, what happened? Dubai district, Sheikh Mohammed's project, what happened? So, you know, you have so many projects which you've already created, and they are not able to sustain and survive. Why are you going around launching new projects? Why are you going around? When will they learn their lesson? Instead of sorting out the mess that they have, they are busy announcing new projects. And people are not stupid. You know, it's just that people can't talk openly. But they all know this is all bullshit. You are not able to deliver one thing properly. Here's my challenge to all the critics of mine. Tell me what happened to the world island. Tell me what happened. Tell me what happened about Maktoum International Airport. Such a big, massive one. How many people come there and go? Nothing, nobody. It's a waste. The amount of money that is being hemorrhaging there. If you're talking of Mars Science City, there's no demand for Mars Science City. How many people are coming for Logistics City? How many are coming for that? Dubai World Central. This is a Dubai government project. Tell me, what happened to Dubai World Central? What happened to Logistics City? Nobody's there. So then what you're going to do in Mars Science City? Who the fuck is going to come to Mars Science City, man? Which will be devoted to research and education as well as entertainment. Entertainment is more like it. That I'll believe. By the way, talking of entertainment, what happened to Lego City? What happened to Warner Brothers project? What happened to Disneyland or whatever? All those big, big lands. Seven Loop or Seven Roller Coaster or something. All these themed parks is going in billions of dollars of loss. You're not able to keep that afloat, and now you're going to have another entertainment project. To enhance the space credentials, Haza Al-Mansouri became UAE's first astronaut serving on the International Space Station in 2019. Well, congratulations. That was a good achievement. But like I call it, he's a space tourist. You pay money, sit on an aircraft from Russia, launched from Russia, with Russian technology. He just has to sit there, go to space, be a coordinator and come back. If you pay 20, 30 or 100 million, anybody would do that. Elon Musk himself would do that. So anyway, okay, then the latest marketing drive includes the semi-official story. I like the way he put semi-official story of the mission fed to the media. It follows the usual Emirati storyline of a benevolent and far-sighted ruler, in this instance, Dubai's ruler, Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, ordering up a space mission, and presto, 6 years, a plucky and determined team of young scientists and engineers launch an interplanetary probe. The guy's a good writer. Sheikh Mohammed's PR team always likes to project Sheikh Mohammed as a visionary, as a leader, and he's working hard on his brand, he's working hard on his image, so there's no problems over there. Okay. Of course, this was done with a little help from our friends, a team of seasoned NASA scientists and engineers, most of them from the University of Colorado. which is true because I spoke to one of my American friends. He said the majority of the engineers, the main people, were American NASA scientists and engineers. Just what they showed on the media is all Emiratis. They didn't show the actual team. They showed the Emiratis are taking the walkie-talkie, typing something on their computer. It was so funny. It looked like he's typing an Excel sheet or he's chatting with someone or some figures are moving. What were they doing? They were just sitting there. Just look at the video. They were sitting there typing, click, 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 click. And one lady is sitting there. Nothing. They're not doing anything. They're just sitting there. Right? Click, click, click. Then one guy is walking. Another guy is walking. Click, click, click. They're doing nothing. So it was so funny. It kind of looked like before the live session started, they were giving instructions. Okay, you look busy. You sit here. You sit there. Act busy. And act like you're doing work. And then once a while, they would make their head gear proper. And they would sit there. And everyone's wearing a mouth mask. And nobody's talking. Everyone's silent. Yeah, it was so funny, man. It looked like a rehearsed one of those, you know, when you have these fake ads or which they want to show that a company is very busy. So you have these paid actors to sit and this thing. Not saying that they are paid actors, but they're definitely, none of them are NASA scientists. None of them. They're not NASA scientists. They're not sitting in NASA. They're just Emirati, some people with little bit of knowledge. And I'm sure some of them are just sitting there doing nothing. What were they doing? Look at the video. You'll see that they were not doing anything. Okay, then what? Who was responsible and how much amal is anybody's guess. But considering that 6 years ago, there was almost no one in UAE qualified to engineer a probe and plan a mission. Beautifully said. This one kind of nails it on the head because the fact of the matter is, 6 years ago, where was anyone? Tell me. See, think about this statement. 6 years ago, there was nobody was an engineer, nobody was an astronaut. So in 6 years, you expect to believe that they managed to create a team that is as good as United States NASA. Think about it. In 6 years, can you actually build that kind of infrastructure? No matter how successful you are. Elon Musk has dedicated his entire life, and it was in the limelight. It was literally for everyone to see, and he is still struggling. Yee! But in UAE's case, I mean, nothing was there, and all of a sudden, boom, boom, you know, we are NASA scientists. Come on, man. It takes years and years of trial and error. You can't suddenly just do it. And think about it. Does UAE have the financial capacity to handle this? Hey, doggy. How are you? This doggy likes to play with me. How are you? He has two different eyes, you know. Two different kind of, one blue and one black. Anyway, okay, then what it says is, like the rest of the Arab world, the UAE suffers a severe science deficit. And even though it is certainly wealthy enough to generously support the endeavor, it's not wealthy enough. They have to pay back $31 billion, which has still not been paid. So they are having a tough time because they have these failed projects that they need to keep pumping money. And with the COVID-19, even Emirates Airlines, UAE's flagship carrier, is hemorrhaging cash in billions. So all the visionary statements and everything else that they had is all gone down the drain. It has taught a lot of institutes of higher education, but their mission is to turn out graduates, not conduct research. Kind of true. They want more and more people, which is kind of good for the younger generation, actually. There's nothing wrong here. Okay, then, very few of those graduates go on to doctorates, or even fewer their PhDs to pursue a research career. 100%. Because most of the Emiratis only work in UAE. They don't go anywhere else. By the way, this statement is very powerful. I want you to literally pay attention to this. In Nature's Index of World Scientific Organization, the UAE ranks 49 out of 50. Imagine, UAE ranks 49 out of 50, edging over Vietnam. In physics, it's even lower. I mean, what a powerful statement. Here, UAE has to admit checkmate. UAE is 49 out of 50. And it's beating out a country like Vietnam. Just think about it. In science, okay? I mean, how many Emirati scientists do you know? How many Emiratis are PhD holders at Oxford or Harvard? Or, I mean, UAE is still a small little baby. See, I'm not discounting what UAE has done. Mars, congratulations. Very big, great achievement. But let's face it, it's PR, okay? Then what they say is, unlike the rest of the Arab world, which a few exceptions like Saudi Arabia, the UAE is at least trying to do something about the problem, which is totally true, which is good. The Mars mission is about PR, but at least it's PR in the service of good cause. Once again, I'll give UAE a heads up for that. So, like I said, it's not simply about bashing UAE. Everything is bad. There are some things which are good. The Emiratis want to build a high-tech economy that will be very hard to do without homegrown research and development backed by critical mass of scientists. This is also true. You cannot succeed in this endeavor without having a team of your homegrown talent. And that is, no amount of money can make that happen. Okay, it has to come within a population. First and foremost, you don't have a population at all. In UAE's population, only 10 or 12% is Emirati. Remaining all are other nationalities. So how can you even claim? And you don't offer citizenship. You just offer a passport for rich investors. And rich investors don't give a fuck about all this. You know, they just care about money. Okay, then, as Omar Sharif, the mission's project manager, told Nature last July when Amal was lifted into space, the Mars mission is a self-conscious mega project aimed at causing a big shift in the mindset. The driver is not space, it's economic. So good. At least they're being honest about it. There may be cheaper, more practical ways to encourage a new generation of scientists, but that's not the way UAE does things. Dubai have built an extraordinary skyscraper. It spent $217 million to build the tallest Burj Al Arab. The Mars mission reportedly cost $200 million. But unlike other showcase projects, the PR value in boasting how little was spent, least critics don't, the Emiratis are buying their way into space. It may have cost more than $200 million, but from UAE's perspective, it's money well spent, which is true, which is not bad. Their money, they have spent, kudos to them. I mean, why should anyone complain? And like I said, they are smart. Let's give Dubai that credit. They are smart, they are intelligent. At least they are doing what most other nations are not doing. That doesn't mean that UAE can buy its way into science by funding research institutes, doctoral programs, and interplanetary exploration. The Saudis have been at this game for some time, and the results aren't encouraging. Even though they have a much larger pool of human capital to draw on. Absolute, they have nailed this fact brilliantly. Saudis, there are much more Saudis. But then Saudis, majority of them, not all, majority of them are lazy because they get so many subsidies from the government. So why should they work hard? You don't have to take my word on it. Just go down to Saudi, fly down there, have a look at how open the economy is, open-minded their religion is. Have a debate or discussion with them and you'll come to know. Then, the kingdom still relies on foreign talent and smoke and mirrors to shore up its image of emerging scientific power, which is true. Modern science is all about money, often lots of it, but also requires a culture that creates inquiry, a free exchange of ideas, and readiness to disperse with the old ones that don't stand up to the scrutiny, which not just Arabs, but the religion of Islam, if anything is critical against it, it doesn't accept it. Try speaking about the evolution, theory of evolution. They'll say it's a theory. But they'll say, what? Even though it's a wordplay. But they'll consider Islam, the religion, as a fact. But science, with its evidence, of dinosaur bones, which nowhere is shown in the Quran, that is not real. So what do you do? Israel's scientific prowess, for one, wasn't the fruit of generous funding and thrives to this day without it. And this is true, huh? Israel is the most advanced country where science, scientific research, where, it's very simple. Israel is a major superpower where intelligence, AI, technology, I don't know how they do it, but it's incredible. Just like in hoping a Mars mission will somehow spur a scientific renaissance, the UAE is hoping ties with Israel will do the same, but it will take a lot more than just marketing and normalization. So this was the article that was shared. I totally agree with almost everything that is said in this article. There's nothing I don't agree with. So what do you think? Do you think this article has substance? I'm pretty sure the supporters of UAE or the supporters of Dubai would say, yeah, you're just a hater, you're just jealous, or whatever. But then, here's my question. Can you prove the statements in this wrong? And if you can prove the statements wrong, which statement are you talking about? I'll copy paste the link down below in the description, and I'll share the screenshots. Okay, I've shared some of them. Let me know your thoughts. I'd be very interested and keen to know which parts are wrong and what is your overall opinion about this. I've given a balanced argument praising UAE where UAE should be praised, and exposing it where the weaknesses are due. So let me know your thoughts. This is me signing off. You guys take care.